is? Do you know what this is? This is a tent pad. That's right. This is a tent pad. You know, to use with the tent. It makes the ground nice and comfy and cozy. That's right. And I have to keep it low because I think the neighbors are home again. So I have to keep it down. But anyway, this is a... See, I buy this. I buy this tent pad for next camping trip. That's right, I did. It's going to save money. But the thing is, they don't tell you which side is supposed to face up. See? There's a smoother side like this. And there's a corrugated, you know, like a corrugated bumpy side like this. And they don't even tell you which side is supposed to face up. And not only that, they don't tell you whether it goes inside the tent or outside the tent. So, we're just going to have to learn the hard way. There's no instructions that came with it. But see, it's a supposedly a half inch thick. And it's soft. See this? Remember this. Bubble Yum is soft. It was a commercial where they used to do that. It had the flavor fiend. And he used to... the puppet that bubbled in the commercial. Remember that? He used to go, Bubble Yum is soft. Because it wasn't supposed to break your teeth when you chewed it and bubbled with it. But anyway, it was... And I don't know whether this goes inside the tent or outside the tent because nobody told me. And other camping gear I have, there's this. Actually, I had this on the last trip too. But this is a lantern. Can you say lantern? Sure you can. It's a lantern. That's exactly what it is. And it's gonna, but I had that on the last one. So see, I've got camping gear, I have a sleeping bag too. And of course the tent itself. Now, when I went to, a few weeks ago, on my camping trip where I went to, Nebraska. That turned out to be the mischief rating went up because you know what we had to do? You know what we had to do on our Nebraska trip? We had to plop stuff. That's right. We had to put things in the toilet. We had to clog up that awesome beast that we call the Tinkletorium. Because the park in Nebraska where we camped out did not have garbage cans. So guess where all the garbage had to go? Instead of putting the garbage in the regular garbage can, because they didn't have one, we had to put garbage in the funny garbage can, also known as the toilet. That's right. They had an outhouse there. We had to put all our garbage in the toilet. Because they didn't have garbage cans. The toilet is also known as the funny garbage. Isn't it weird how the toilet is also known as the funny garbage can, but the garbage can is also known as the funny toilet? Isn't that weird? Man, English is a weird language. You know that? Especially American English, because that's the American thing to do, is to... You know, I mean, that's... The American way, you know, is to do stuff like that because the toilet is, I mean, I'm serious. Look, the toilet is the funny garbage can. Well, the garbage can is the funny toilet. CPH, when I even CPH got it backwards. Like one of the guards at CPH, like he held up the picture of the toilet. And he says, "This is not a garbage can." When really the problem wasn't that people, the problem he was talking about, it wasn't people putting garbage in the toilet. It was people pooping in the garbage can. Was the problem he was talking about. So what he really should have been doing, he should have held up a picture of a garbage can and said, "This is not a toilet." See, he was talking about a completely, the precise opposite problem than what the picture was talking about. You know that? He was. See, he said he had a picture of a toilet and said, "This is not a garbage can." Because people, and really that would have been proper, you know, if he was talking about people plopping things. But instead, he wasn't talking about people putting garbage in the toilet. He was talking about people going to the bathroom in the garbage can. So you see, he had his problems mixed up. So. See, he was talking about the opposite problem. Though it's not like there weren't any ploppings either, because somebody did put a chess piece in the toilet once at CPH, which I heard about because I heard somebody say, "Did they get the chess piece out of the toilet yet?" But anyway, in Nebraska, we had to plop things. We had to put garbage in the funny garbage can. So this is a tent pad right here, and there's no instructions on how to use it. It's a half inch thick, and it's soft. Yeah, it's so soft. Yeah. So. So that's how. That's how it works, and it's got straps too, like this. See? Remember back in the 80s when people wore suspenders and they'd do that? Somebody would walk up to the person wearing suspenders and they would go like that. Was that a sonic boom? You snapping the straps on this thing, does that create a sonic boom? You know how people always say that when they flick a towel in the air, that creates a sonic boom. I guess it's sort of like that. So that's right. I buy new camping gear this month. Because next month I'm planning on another fact-finding mission that's going to involve camping. So right now I'm gonna leave you with several photos of the tent from the Nebraska trip.